full orchestra and have people hear it and have it hopefully go into their heart and affect them. That's all I want, really. That's all I want. My experience with music before I found my niche in opera was that I was a little bit disproportionate to most art forms, being 5'11" and not being a ballerina, and I don't know, for whatever reason, the sound of my voice, the size of me. And then when I found opera, all of the strangeness, so to speak, all of the specificity of myself, my person, fit really well. I got to be the understudy of Musetta in La Bohème at BYU, and I was singing the song, and I just thought, I had this earth-shattering moment where I realized, this is what I was born to do. This is my niche on the planet. Garden in my first season as a fully fledged artist. That is, I don't know anyone else that's happened for. That was really crazy. And opera is a unique field in that old time notion of someone stepping in as an understudy in the last minute and saving the day and becoming a star really overnight. It's kind of possible in opera. I mean, that sort of happened for me. I stood on the stage and I opened my mouth and it's the biggest room I've ever sang in, and I felt the spirits of those predecessors under me in the wood. I felt like Pavarotti and Birgit Nilsson and all these amazing voices, Kirsten Flagstad, all of these voices had sung on that very stage, on those very wood panels. And at first I was tempted to be totally terrified out of my mind and do badly as a result of that daunting realization. But ultimately I decided I'm going to add my voice to this room, this historic room. I think the most important thing as an opera singer is to have really solid technique, and I was getting that from BYU. Anytime I can possibly do it, I go back to program and have voice lessons with Daryl Babbage, who I studied with my senior year in undergrad and throughout grad school. So his encouragement and unfailing support of my endeavors has been instrumental to my success. My skill set fits somewhere in the world, that's a wonderful thing to realize, that there's a place for me. The fact that I've been given so many opportunities to keep going down this path and keep discovering new ways of using my instrument and my life experiences, it's just the greatest blessing. I'm really having a great time.